Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my motherfucking channel. Today, we are not in my fucking crusty, dusty, rusty motherfucking apartment. We are outside in the beautiful fucking city of Glendale, California, bitch. So today, I beat my fucking face, put on lashes for like the first time in ever, bitch. One's like falling off, so we're just gonna ignore that throughout the fucking day. Follow me inside, and I wanna show you guys my apartment. I need nothing else, I promise, girl, I swear, I just need somebody to love. Living in the fucking Amazon, like sometimes I'm like walking home and I'm like bright as fucking shit. I'm like, who's on my fucking head? Like, what? Like, insect just fell into my fucking wig. Damn it. Let's go ahead and go inside and follow me. So, as most people are probably fucking confused, like, what is this fucking tapestry doing in the middle of your living room? Bitch, this is my fucking bedroom, but we'll save that for last because it's the most iconic. When you walk in my grand, lofted, so fucking nice apartment, we have a couch that we literally got for free off the side of the fucking road. One of our neighbors was getting rid of it. Still have the tags on and everything. Love a good leather moment. Perfect for the occasional, like, sitting on your face Instagram. And then this fucking stained ass coffee table that one of our friends gave us is so fucking trash. Literally has just like bong stains, like people just ashing on our fucking coffee table. Like, one, rude, but two, it adds character, bitch. This couch is personally my favorite. It was $30 at Goodwill. You know, mama finessed it down to 10, pushed it fucking home with like two trash bags full of clothes because you guys know that's the only place I shop. She's cute, she's comfy. I've woken up here confused and drunk. So yeah, definitely good for a little blackout moment, which you know I specialize in. My fucking roommate brought those fucking chairs. They're cute, they're squeaky, but like they don't ever fucking stop squeaking and I fall off of them every other fucking day, so that's not cute. Most people's kitchens usually have fucking two cabinets, but they don't have a fucking alcoholic living in their apartment. I literally don't know what happened. All I know is that like I woke up one morning like literally full on blackout mode. Like had my tongue down this guy's throat at the club the night before. I like woke up, he was like threatening to kill me. Anyways, pasta noodles were all over, water on the floor. And like this was off, the bag of shredded cheese was still out. It's like, aw, like I tried to make the fucking pasta, but wasn't successful. Blessing in disguise, bitch. My fridge is trash. You guys probably just don't want to see in there because you know mama can't afford fucking groceries. Everything's moldy. I'm kidding. Right here we have my iconic Versace sunglasses that honestly, everybody thinks is like fake. Like, no boo. If I'm gonna flex something, it's gonna be real, you know? My bougie fucking ass, like I literally should sell these and like pay for my rent, but you know what? Never. We have more important things. My fucking waist trainer, because you guys know we can't be anything less than snatched. I just put it on every night, fold it over so it like really suctions up my muffin top. Wake up and hoping to look like I got lipo. Usually it doesn't fucking work and I'm still trash. Right here we have some of my favorite little crop tops. One of my favorite shirts that my best friend Carly gave me, literally thrifted it. The fucking iconic Playboy moment. She's cute or whatever. My second favorite is bitch me. Literally, you guys, well, symbolizes Lila get me, like as a whole. Like somebody's talking shit, like, look at my shirt, bitch. Fucked your boyfriend in it last night. And then my third favorite is from Dolls Kill. One of my friends modeled for Dolls Kill. You guys know, like, mama lives for a good, like, pastel pink Barbie ass fucking moment. Just fucked Ken. What's good, bitch? But I just love it. It's so fucking cute. And then, so yeah, I just have all my other, like, pants, sweatpants, because literally all I fucking wear is comfy ass shit. You guys know this? All the heels on the bottom are just the ones that aren't these. Shout out to the sugar daddy I went out to dinner with for these. Follow me into my room, aka the fucking kitchen. And so this is where I fucking sleep every night. Oh my god, my pants just came unbuttoned, fuck. And then this is my little DIY closet moment. I was kind of scared at first. I was like, how the fuck is my fucking fake bougie ass going to possibly like live in the kitchen, literally, and to like not have like the fattest walk-in closet? Like my collection of my favorite little two pieces, body suits. You guys know I love a good snake skin.
It's definitely cheetah.
Oh my god. Fuck, same thing. That's cheetah, leopard, like snake. Fuck. Oh fuck, I'm always on my hands and knees, you guys. It's getting exhausting. But here we have my favorite Barbie moments because like they're the most important, so they definitely need to stand out. All my like tube top dresses, my neons, and then all my blacks, all my fucking cheetahs, and then snake skin, same fucking thing. Because you guys know I love animal print, like it's just everything. And then, oh, oh, oh. This dress is the one I wore when Paris Hilton liked my fucking Instagram picture, so I'm never getting rid of her. She's a fucking keeper. This one, I haven't fucking worn yet, but it's totally like just fucked Gianni Versace right before he bit the dust. It's not fucked up to say. But like my best friend Carly thrifted this for me and I was like, it's so iconic. Like I need to wear this ASAP with like a fat pair of like black heels or something. I'm so excited to wear this one to like the Grammys one day when I have like my fat rocket titties and like just showing all my boobage possible, because like why the fuck wouldn't I? And then these are all of my favorite crop tops and all of that. And then up here, kind of in the back, I just have like a bunch of obnoxious ass fucking dresses that I thrifted. Like there's one up there that I could get down, but literally it's like as heavy as me. I got her at Goodwill and looked it up online and she was a $2,000 fucking gown and I got at Goodwill Bins, which is like where you just go and like weigh it. So it was so fucking heavy. I was like, bitch, it's gonna be like $40. We pull up to the fucking cashier and I was like, I only have like $550 in my account. And she's like, it's fine, honey, I'll just give it to you for $5. I'm like, that's what I thought, bitch, I'm not paying for it. And then some of my favorite bags, my little Calvin moment, my wannabe Chanel, because I'm a trashy ass fucking bitch and can't afford the real deal. And then this is my room, which literally consists of fucking nothing. I got this the first time right off the fucking plane at LAX. Got in and out, bitch. My first time literally like living in LA. First night, and I pull up. We were smoking a blunt outside and picked this bitch off the side of the street. I was like, there was probably a hobo in it earlier. Like, probably some fucking skunks living in this bitch, but mama needs somewhere to put her fucking clothes, I swear. It's occasionally good to have a little self-timer moment for nudes in bed, and other than that, I guess it holds some of my like favorite tube tops and whatnot. Then I've lost. So yeah, that sign over there that I got at Santa Monica, literally got from like this fucking like homeless person on the side of the road just like painting with a fucking toothbrush. I was like, wait, that's kind of iconic. I need that. Like that in my sense or whatever is considered a necessity. So upstairs are where my roommates live, which you guys don't even want to see their fucking messy, crusty fucking rooms. But yeah, you guys, this is my fucking apartment and I hope you guys enjoy it. Obviously, I look like fucking ass, but that's fucking nothing new, bitch. You guys knew that when you clicked on this video. And honestly, you guys should be even-
Love
that's
that.
That's so rude. And honestly, you guys should be happy that I even fucking cleaned for you guys and got my shit together, aka just put like 4 loads of fucking shit in the laundry to get rid of it and like filled that fucking closet. So yeah, that was my little short apartment tour moment. I hope you guys enjoyed, honestly. I definitely want to show you more things in my day-to-day fucking life, such as like cooking and my fried ass just like trying to function. And if you guys did like this video, make sure to give it a big ass motherfucking thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button down below. And until next time, you guys, stay true. Stand there and watch me. Now get the fuck out of my apartment. Because